Hey, what's up guys, Diplex here again. Welcome back to Men of War Assault Squad 2. Today I have something pretty exciting lined up for us, and it's gonna be, of course, some German armored trains. We have two of them. They're gonna be riding side by side, and they're gonna be assisting the main assault that's gonna take place up here on the right side of the two railroads. So I am pretty damn excited to see how these trains are gonna do. There are three variants. Each train consists of five wagons, so to speak, and we're going to take a closer look at them right away. The one in the front and back have the sort of like a Panzer IV turret on top of it with a shorter barrel or a shorter cannon or a gun. You know, apparently if you say barrel with anything that's over 20 millimeter, they get upset. I learned that in the Swedish army during my brief time there. They said, if you go to the people who ride the APCs, the infantry fighting vehicles, namely the, what's it called? IFV 90 or something like that. They will get very upset if you call the gun on the turret for a barrel. What's the thickness of the barrel? They say Eldrör, which is like firing tube, more like a gun, cannon, whatever you want to call it. So, yes, that was an unnecessary discussion about that. But anyway, this is the 75 mil. We have a flak, which is, I believe, is a flak 38. Can we check? Yes, 2 centimeter, flak 38, yes. Then we have a 50 mil gun right here, which is from a, I don't know what to call this turret. It looks like something I haven't seen before. Another flak 38, and of course, ending it with another 75 mil turret in the back. And then I don't even know how many MG42s there's on these. 1, 2, 3, 4. Plus 5 with the gun up there, and then that's 5. So there's 25 plus the ones on top here. 25 and, yes, exactly 29. So that's quite gruesome. A lot of machine guns as well. So 29 machine guns, 3 turrets with AT guns, and 2 flaks. It's going to be a lot of firepower storming down on the Russians. And on the right side here, we have the main assault, which isn't huge, so to speak, but the focus is going to be on the trains with some infantry back here backing it up. So what is that? Why is there a texture glitch in the map? Why has no one covered this up? Is it that hard? Okay. And over here, we have the Russian defense. Let's take a look. First wave, it's going to be mainly infantry and AT guns. Got the train station over here with like a warehouse with more AT guns. We've got the SIS-2 and SIS-3. The SIS-2 is the 57 mil variant. This is the 76, I believe. Plenty of machine guns and whatnot. Some tanks back here, the T-34-85, a KV-1 back there, and some pretty cool positions up here in case the trains do get so far. So without further ado, yes, let's just start the video. And the battle, of course. I was quite humbled to see the support and all the comments and the views that I got on the previous video. It felt really nice to wake up and be like, wow, that was really nice. I could really need something like that, and it keeps me motivated. I am undoubtedly tired because I haven't been sleeping well, but this really does keep me excited. So without further ado, let's click start. We might have to run this a few more times and alter the trains a bit to get a better action going, but we'll see what the current setup will do. Both trains are going to be moving out quite slowly. And here goes the tanks. By the way, the tanks are so detailed. Look at the wheels spinning there above the tracks. Damn, that was cool. Look at that building. Taking so much fire. Infantry moving up now with the main assault. What seems to be a Lux moving up as well, a Panzer II. Some Panthers. Here come the trains. Ooh. Flaks are already firing, putting a lot of suppressing fire on the Russians back there. Oh. I think the gun just struck the Panzer IV back there. Or Panzer II, sorry. So that one's going to go down. Very light, but, you know, good to get some reconnaissance with. Quick. And fairly versatile with its 20mm gun. I can't even hear anything. I can't even hear myself talk. So I was like about to make some major mispronunciations and tongue twisters from not even being able to hear myself. I'm going to sound like I'm deaf. No offense to deaf people, but I know you can't hear me anyway. Say it. So anyway, Look at that. Rolling in. Coming to a halt. Probably just to get some good fire in, more accurate rounds. These flaks are just going crazy. The ones back here, not really seeing any targets right now. I do think the main guns on top of these front runners are going to be targeting armored targets so far. There's only infantry in the area. We do have some tanks rolling in, though. There we go. Look at that. A double salvo. Boom, boom. Aiming down this T-34-85 coming in. I think those 75mm turrets will be able to deal with it quite nicely. It does seem to be bouncing a bit, but the tracks have been disabled, and I see fire. But there we go. It's finally taken out. This Tiger is looking pretty healthy. But what happened to the other tanks? There was a Panther over here. This one's taking fire, and the one back there is detracked. So that's not going to be doing much. Infantry moving up, though. Trying to assist the armor. Currently just trying to get to the station. More Russian infantry moving in. There's a lot of them coming in right now. We have another T-34-85. Two of them back here. Some sandbag positions. And the train is moving again. It's gonna be rolling up to assist the rest of the attack. And this time it probably won't stop for anything. All guns blazing. Look at that. The rate of fire on those 50mm guns in the center. Slightly higher than the 75 mils to the front and rear. But this train is just going side by side right now. So I'm a little worried about, like, what do you call that? A collateral damage? That one shell might do more damage than it should have in case they were riding separately, not side by side. But it does bring up a lot of firepower. Look at that. That is sweet. I wonder what this train would do or how it would perform with only the 75mm turrets. Like a train of 10 wagons and the 75mm Panzer IV turret on it. That would be pretty, pretty insane. Could you call that gun a stub nose? Because I know that like a pistol or a revolver that's like shortened is usually called like a stub nose. But then again, that's a handheld weapon. This is an actual gun on a tank, so not quite sure. But they're moving up. How's it looking with German infantry? They too are moving up. Tiger has been abandoned. Most likely destroyed, though, not just abandoned for the sake of it. Or perhaps these Germans are big fans of trains, and they're like, our Tiger can't move, screw that, I'm not missing out on the action of my life. I have some Russian 30 mils back here, or 40 mils, I think. And a KV-1 is moving now. I thought it would be cool if it ran down the tracks. Damn, it's putting some good fire on the train, and the train isn't really responding to it. Might be out of range. Don't think so, though. Could be that the guns are destroyed. Flaks are down. And geez, look at this position back here now. They're going to be putting a lot of fire on those two trains. We got the two SIS-3s, mortars, machine gunners, infantry, all firing at the two trains advancing right now. Rear guns are firing. I think we might have an issue with the train. I think we might have lost one. One of them has just stopped. It's very likely that the front train has gone down. Oh, look at that. Oh, jeez. Chaos on the railway. KV-1 moving up as well. This guy's like riding solo. Okay, the trains have come to a stop. How are the guns looking? Let's take a look. Can't even look at it. It's practically down and destroyed. Yep, the top guns are too damaged. They took too much AE fire. Those guns were nasty. The Russian artillery definitely put a stop to it. This train is still moving. You know, the machine guns can surely fire, but there's not much sense to it because look at this. This KV-1 is going to have its own roaming freedom with it. So let's do this. Let's do something cool. Let's have everyone like jump out. Abandon the train! Well, too damaged and unable to move. It's time to get the infantry back on foot. All these train crew members, though, have got AT grenades and other interesting weapons, so they might actually be able to stop that KV-1 from continuing its predatorial behavior up here on the main road. Oh, these guys were finally not told to get out, but the train itself actually did get destroyed, so they were kind of forced to. Inevitably. Got any tanks moving up here? You repaired and stuff? Cool. This guy's repaired. Let's just send him up for the sake of it. Infantry still trying to move up. Oh, okay. I think they just took out one of these guns with their handheld guns. Let's take a look at the millimeter on this. It's 37. Well, that's very specific. Why not just keep it at even numbers? What could another 3 millimeters do to damage the reputation of that gun? 40 mil? Come on. It's going to do a little better. It doesn't hurt adding a little size to the caliber you're shooting with. So the infantry's, undoubtedly kept back here. And there's mortars bombarding, but the tanks aren't... Oh, between me, the Panther, and this KV-1, I'm not going to do any more controlling. I kind of want it to be up to them, but why are you aiming the turret to the left? This is cleared out. You see all the bullet holes in the ground from those 20 mils with the impacts? Uh-oh, the only thing separating the two now got destroyed. But this KV-1 is not aiming down the Panther yet. And this Panther is neither aiming down the KV-1, but there we go. One shot. Oh, look at that. I think those were penetrating rounds. Why didn't it shoot at the KV-1 before? It's clearly a functional tank. What is that? Yeah. Tracks. But the rest is fine. And you've got rounds, so why aren't you firing? And you do have 4 crew members in the tank, so there we go, they just fired. And this KV-1 is taking some hand grenade attacks, so to speak. Okay, so the second Panther was repaired and is moving up, and there's a commissar over here that survived the attack back here. He must have fled and left his poor Russian comrades to die. That's such a privileged man. And now he's having a one-on-one fight against the German submachine gunner back there, but 2 Panthers moving up now. So, once again, let me get it straight. All guns and everything is functional in this one, but yet it chooses not to target the KV-1 positioned right in front of it. It just fired a grenade from the turret. Where did that grenade come out of? Because it shot a grenade from the turret. We all saw that. I can't seem to find it. Is this like some World of Tanks stuff? Yet again, you're not going to shoot each other. See, now he's turning. Instead, you're going to battle it out with his gun battery. The commissar's like... This gun is down. Actually, it's probably not down. No, yeah, it's down. And you can't repair it, can you? Nope, it is finito. So there's one gun over here. There's some stuff over there, but they're not really anti-armored assets. And here's just 2 of those AA guns. Okay, commissar, German submachine gunner. Okay, we're going to do something else. We're going to wrap it up here. This is kind of like... I don't want to say anything insultive to anyone, but this is a little retarded. So, it's a little reversed. It's a little backwards, so to speak. So, I'm going to let these guys not dabble it out here because they're kind of embarrassing themselves. So, we're going to restart this, and I'm going to do train only on the Russian forces. And we're going to add a bunch of wagons. Should be pretty cool. See you in a second. All right, we've added quite a lot of wagons to the armored trains. It ended over here before, but we've added another, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, it's quite a big amount per train. So, that makes it a total of 9. There's 10 on this side, right? Yes, 10. Why is there 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? Why is there 11 on this side? Okay, doesn't really matter. It doesn't have to be even. They're separate, okay? They're individually placed. You know, some commander had his favorites and... obviously purchased 1 more wagon to his train, and the other one's just sitting here with a grin on his face. But, yes, I thought I'd turn it to nighttime, but we'll just miss out on some cool visuals anyway. Although, night does add a lot of cool visuals. But, no German support except for the trains. This is the only thing they have this time around. The Russian defense remains the same completely, but the trains won't be stopping here this time around. They'll be going straight through. I think this is going to be pretty chaotic, and they're not even synced up, so they won't, like, double-cross each other as much as they did before. Double-cross. It sounds like betraying someone. You guys like betraying each other? Trains? No, you two should stay friends. Just stay in each other's lane. Or in separate lanes. And then you guys won't argue that much. And it's not a race, okay? What should we nickname these trains? I don't know. I think they've got enemy contact. Yep. Some screenshot time, are you fucking kidding me? Sorry about the swearing, I had to. This is cool. Damn. Why are you guys stopping? I told you not to stop. Because we lost the wagon. Keep going. Someone ruined the railroad? Is that what? Keep going. What the fuck? There's something wrong with the railroad this time around. Why would there be something? There was nothing wrong with the broadband. This is not an internet service. Okay, train has lost power. These things are messed up. What if I? Oh, it's probably just because of the connectors. God damn it! All right, 1 second. There we go. Now this should work. Now they should be able to just ram right through. Let me make sure all the scripts are like. Yeah, no, this is all making sense. Good. I didn't have any waypoints for them to stop at, so they're gonna ride all the way through. I was thinking for a second that perhaps I should do something about the health on the front two wagons, because if they die, everyone else is going to break down. I could turn the rest into a locomotive so that they can push on, but they're not going to because they're not scripted to. You know what's even cooler though, and even safer in this time of day? Not in the time of day, but in a situation like this. I'm going to stop them. I'm going to go in here. I'm going to turn off the locomotive. And I'm going to take the back ones, these dudes, and turn them into locomotives. And then I'm going to just take this guy here. I'm going to just tell him to push all the way up here. And that's gonna have to do. Oh geez, it's a lot faster this time. The strength on that rear one. They've been waiting all day to just prove their point. It's gonna be a fast train. Nitro, fast train. Isn't that like a rock song? Well, what if you come to a halt? Almost the exact same place. Keep going. I'm taking executive command. Keep going. Ram it right through. Look at all these guns, man. What's even gonna do about this? Huh? It's gonna be a real headache. Most of these infantrymen here aren't even that eager to fight. They're kind of running back. Hell train has come to town, boys. Oh, shit. That's a volley and a half. I think there's some problems with the there's a problem with the number of trains and the speed they're going at. They used to go slower before, but I think this kind of speed is likely to make them derail or something. This is the best train trip of my life. This is backpacking done right. Run through Europe like this, just guns blazing. This is what Hitler should have done to invade. Should have taken all the railroads leading to Moscow and just placed armored trains on them and just done this, you know? Of course, they'd be bombed to death by airplanes and long-range artillery and whatnot, but... And since they only run on a railroad, what happens if you cut off the railroad? Well, then you just... when they turn into cars, they deploy wheels or something. Or tracks. And then they're essentially just a tank, so it doesn't even make a difference. But... I do think we have a little bit of a trouble here. Slight derailing issue. These trains aren't the best. They look like they're built off of the... AFV7, or is it the AV7, the German tank during World War I? Looks similar to it. Yeah, this is what I call a train mess. We've got some complete derailments here. This turret has even fallen off of the tank, or the The train. Infantry laying down some fire. Guys, I think we're going to wrap this one up. I really just wanted to do a video showcasing and featuring these trains. I hope you guys have a good time, and I'll see you guys soon again. All right. Ciao.